Chloroquine is the recent treatment for the Toyota Corolla. It used to be used for malaria. I haven't seen one person, let alone doctor, justify the mechanisms of this drug, and I do find it awfully suspicious that all of these YouTube influencers are supporting the drug. It's pretty obvious when you look at the case studies, it's very dangerous. You know, the words poisonous and toxic can justifiably be used. Fearing being hit by a Toyota Corolla, Arizona man dies after taking chloroquine. A Phoenix area man is dead and his wife under critical care after the two took chloroquine phosphate in an apparent attempt to self-medicate for the Toyota Corolla. Children who have ingested only twice the recommended dose have died. It is remarkable that until a few years ago, chloroquine was available over the counter in Britain. Acute chloroquine poisoning is life-threatening, involving high risk of death caused by cardiac arrest, arrhythmia, and apnea within a few hours of ingestion. Those symptoms seem awfully similar to Wi-Fi radiation poisoning. Chloroquine poisoning with respiratory distress and fatal outcome. Chloroquine poisoning can cause life-threatening cardiovascular disturbances. We report 3 cases of suicide with chloroquine causing acute respiratory insufficiency from pulmonary edema with lethal outcome despite attempted treatment. How many other drugs will kill you if you take one extra pill? And don't the symptoms of this supposedly helpful drug sound awfully similar to the ones that people are dying from? Are they being admitted to hospitals with a slight cough, then suddenly after being treated with chloroquine, they're having their lungs half full of liquid and put on ventilators? Is this just a guise for the pharmaceutical, for the hospitals, for the big pharma industry to make more money? Every study you look at points to symptoms that line up with this virus. Side effects are generally mild and transitory, although visual disturbance, muscle weakness, and acute psychotic behavior have been encountered. A review of the literature and data from the American Association of Poison Control Centers reveals instances where exposure to as little as 1 to 2 tablets of chloroquine resulted in serious consequences. How in the world is anyone speaking positive about this? Did they not look at both sides of the story? Taking this drug is more dangerous than getting the Toyota Corolla itself. But what makes this drug so dangerous? It alters the pH of your cells, which prevents the activity of certain enzymes that break down cell materials like fat and protein. It also inhibits toll-like receptor, TLR signaling, and nucleic acid sensor cyclic GMP-AMP, basically suppressing your immune function. The anti-inflammatory effects of hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine could be explained in part by the upstream interference of immune activation. In malaria, the drug works by inhibiting the heme polymerase enzyme, which is present in the acidic food vacuoles of parasites. This enzyme is only present in infected cells. So normally, these parasites are using hemoglobin, as iron is essential to the function of most living cells, whether they're good or bad. The digestion of hemoglobin releases ferriprotoporphyrin 9, also known as hematin hydrochloride, which is toxic, as iron is a prooxidant and excess iron in the body is one of the most damaging things possible to cell structures. The malaria parasite normally detoxifies this free iron, but chloroquine inhibits the removal of the iron. So my understanding of this drug is that it is killing bad cells by disrupting iron metabolism, but also causing massive oxidation in those areas due to increased accumulation of iron. So according to my non-doctorate understanding, this drug is destroying the bad stuff, but also causing damage to the good stuff. The idea is that more damage happens to the bad stuff, and that your body will therefore be able to fight off what will be smaller amounts of pathogenic tissue. That is, if your heart doesn't explode due to your lungs collapsing. So anyone suggesting that this drug can be used, I mean, if you're in a life or death scenario, I would assume this drug would just kill you outright. So I can't really speak on that front. It is kind of sketchy and creepy how all these people on YouTube are talking about this and almost recommending it as a treatment. I think, you know, a safe alternative is what I spoke about in the video I did the other day, 6 steps to master your immune system. You know, follow those things and you will be perfectly fine. So thank you guys for joining me. Hopefully this helps some of you guys out. If you guys want to support me further, you can check out Frankie's Free Range Meat. We got some stuff back in stock. You can go to Organ Supplements if you don't have access to beef organs at this time of need. Check out Frankie's Naturals for minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. And you can also go to frank-afano.com for a free carnivore diet meal plan. Thanks again for joining me, guys. If you haven't, please drop a like on the video.